Hello, please welcome on my presentation about how to find vulnerabilities in VMaaS. And so let's start. So what is the VMaaS? Yeah, we know the VMaaS is actually a pretty lame name. And nobody from us really likes it, but we continue with it. It was just first time we started using, and yeah, it's with us forever. And actually, it's for vulnerability metadata as a service. And it does mean it's an API service, it's a RESTful service, and it's completely stateless, and it's not authenticated. And its primary goal is to find vulnerabilities for RPM-based systems. And we do that based on static evaluation of the package profile of given systems. And so it does mean it doesn't take into account any mitigation applied on that system. There are also secondary goals that VMaaS provides, and these are for providing metadata for about packages, repositories, errata, CVEs, and so on. And so what are these technical details about VMaaS? So it's a set of microservices written mostly in Python. And we are using Postgres database, and this set of Docker containers is deployable using Docker Compose or using OpenShift. And we are not from the web applications. We are not directly connecting to the database and fetching data. We are using some pre-computed structures to achieve higher speeds of getting results. So here I will just explain the architecture. We have five containers. User can access publicly two containers. This is the web application. This is the main entry point of all APIs, and the API idle container for just getting some insights how it works. And in the backend, we have a repo scan container, which is used for scanning repositories and fetching CVE repositories and so on. And the repo scan and the web application is communicating on internal web sockets. And the repo scan component is the only component that's actually touching the database. And also the repo scan component is pre-processing data from database and making it available from the web application. Also, the repo scan component has its own API, which can be authenticated and is used by administrator to add new repositories or CVEs. There are a couple of endpoints. I can show you more. Okay, so the updates API is the main API to get vulnerabilities of your package profile. And we have all APIs in variants for get request and post request. Get request is always to get a single updates for single package, Nebra, or updates or details about single CVE, or to get the details about single repository, get details about single erratum, and so on. And the post request is used to get
these things for multiple entities at once. So if I look it on that more, it looks like that. In the request, you can specify package list and repository list and release vars, base args. So, and these three attributes are not actually required. There are some mechanisms that will guess the repositories and the related products and will return you some available updates even if you don't specify these three things. And this is how the response look like. You will get for some old package, you will get available updates, and you will also find out where in which repository you will find this update.
Sorry, could you make it out of the mirror?
Of course. And also you will receive all necessary details about the updated package. And also the error tool which will provide this package. And then you can take the error tool and you can ask about details about this error tool which will return you for example, affected CVEs or some descriptions and metrics. And the same for CVEs API. There are also some CVSS scores or, and so on. And yeah, these are the APIs we are using, we are providing. These are public APIs. Then for administrators, we have, of course, the APIs for adding repositories and or syncing repositories and CVEs and other utilities for managing the VMaaS instance. Okay, so and we in Red Hat are providing one public instance of VMaaS, which basically contains metadata about everything what Red Hat is providing in Red Hat subscription management. And this is about 18,000 repositories, basically. It's mostly about, I don't know how many content sets multiplied by different architectures, multiplied by different release versions. And we store, and in these repositories is contained about 1,800,000 packages. And we also store here the CVEs obtained from NIST and from Red Hat CVE feeds. And I can show you a demo how to use that. And I try to write some simple script which will is it visible? Or can I make the font bigger? Okay. Okay, this is the RHEL 6.9 server, which is basically basic installation, not updated, base minimal package set, and it's 6.9, so it's like I don't know, 1.5 year old. So there will be multiple vulnerabilities. So I have here VMaaS report tool, which is some thin client which will contact the VMaaS server and provides the package list of this system and tries to get available updates, calls few APIs and displays it on the output. This is just a simple tool, basically. It's available on PyPy. And here I will just display some details about currently configured VMaaS server. We just display version and the version of data provided here. We see it was changed like today at 3 a.m. last time. And so I will just, on the system, I will run this tool. And I will get a list of vulnerable packages I have here on this RHEL 6.9 server. It's quite a lot, but not that much. And here, list of unapplied security advisories, and also list of CVEs, which are fixed by these security advisories. It's just a simple listing. Actually, in the data return, you can also assign the CV. You have also CVs assigned to errata, and you can see here all these associations, what's fixed by what, and so on. This is just a simple listing. This is on RHEL 6.9 server, and I have also example on RHEL 7.4, which is also more than 1 year old. And just a bit different set of data. So we don't have any Fedora or other repositories synced in our Red Hat VMaaS instance, but it's possible definitely to sync anything. But there is definitely some lack in support of SUSE repositories and CentOS, because there is no update. There are no update infos provided by default. But it may change. We may support for also different sources in future. We have a couple of challenges we need to solve in VMaaS, but also we try to solve most of them, but not every problem has some easy solution. So some of these problems are not fixed yet, and maybe they are never will be fully fixed. For example, we need to choose between speed and what everything we will cache, and how much memory it will actually web application use, because we try to cache as much as possible in the web application. Okay.
And the other microphone table.
Sorry?
The black box on the table, the microphone, just stand close to that.
Is it better? Is it better somehow?
You just need to speak.
Okay. Yeah, this is the problem about speed and caching and memory usage. Our web application containers are taking more than 1 gigabyte of memory, and it contains almost everything we need to return to users. It's quite difficult to balance the cache data and the speed and the memory usage. So the second issue is, for example, the automatic product and repository updating, because if we store, for example, 18,000 repositories, and if there is no mechanism to tell these repositories are updated. The repositories are static files on some HTTP server, just some metadata stored in a repo data directory, and it can be time consuming to download all refreshed metadata. So, but we can try to optimize that. And the another problem is. There are differences between in CVE metadata if we take this CVE metadata from different sources. For example, if we take the CVE metadata from Red Hat and we take this CVE data from NIST or Mitre, so all of these organizations are using different metrics for example, CVSS score, and these numbers are different, so we need to choose which value we will use. And another problem are inconsistencies in repository metadata, and this is the endless problem, because even between Red Hat repositories there are differences, because every repository metadata were generated at different point in time, so they can be in different format. Use different checksum for packages and can use some different timestamps. There are basically many problems with that in general, but yeah, it's getting better slowly, but it's getting better. So this is some challenges we need to solve. And what's the future of VMaaS? Basically, what everybody can VMaaS used for? It's an API service, so it can be easily integrated with some other projects. Mostly, it's useful for system management projects or content management projects. And actually, the VMaaS is already used in Red Hat Insights, and there are some ideas how to use it in Red Hat Satellite maybe in future, and basically these are some internal Red Hat projects where this VMaaS can be used for. Okay, so that's it. Do you have any questions? Okay.
Is the product open source? Can I run an instance
So the question was if the project is open source. Yes, the VMaaS itself is open sourced, so you can deploy it as you want in your environment. Any other? Okay.
Do you have any time frame when you want to integrate VMaaS into a regular supply?
So the question was if there is any time frame to integrate VMaaS with Red Hat Satellite. Yeah, I think there are no concrete time frames for this yet. This was just an idea I heard. So it's not planned yet, basically, and it's not sure if it will be planned. But it was just some discussions. Okay.
Do you have any plans to pull in Fedora repos?
Sorry?
Do you have any plans to pull in Fedora repos?
Yes. Yeah, we also, the question was if we have any plan to pull Fedora repos. Yes. Yes, we definitely have plans to also contain Fedora repos in our stable instance. But we had some issues with that because the packages were colliding. But it was probably resolved yet, resolved already, but we did not update.
Do you know what the timeline for that is?
I don't know. Okay. Please say again. The question was if we can store, if we can scan devices in future. What do you mean by scanning devices?
Well, there are schools called Cisco, Juniper, other devices, and
well, we are using RPM-based evaluation, so yeah, there were some plans to investigate how we can integrate with other scanning vulnerabilities projects, but currently there are no plans to scan differently in VMaaS than using RPMs. Okay. Yes.
What would it take to add third-party repositories, like for example RPM Fusion? I mean, one thing would be to implement on your side, but the other thing would be what metadata they would need to provide for it to be consumable.
Okay. So the question was what effort is needed to get for example RPM Fusion into the VMaaS? Yes. So if the RPM Fusion is providing update info.xml, which has the provided advisories and CVEs, CVE associated to these advisories, so then it's definitely already possible to pull RPM Fusion to VMaaS. Any other questions?